So when I think about what's happening with the cost of living in this country, I see it as an imbalance between supply and demand. And I just want to make sure, as an economist, you understand it the same way. We had an administration and policies of this administration that squeezed supply with higher taxes, with higher and more regulations, higher cost, and with paying people more than they made in their previous job for a long time, which created a labor shortage. We now have, we still have a lower job participation rate than we did prior to COVID. That's the supply side squeeze. On the demand, overstimulating demand, we flooded the market with federal money. Started with $1 trillion in so-called COVID relief. We had $1 trillion from prior COVID relief unspent. The IRA was supposed to be deficit reducing, or at least pay for itself. Now I think your update is that it will cost $300 billion in additional deficit spending. And the total debt, new debt, since this president's been in office, is $6 trillion. So you've got squeeze in demand, I mean, in supply, and overstimulated demand. You have record 40-year inflation. Is that how you see it, and is that an accurate depiction of what has brought us to the recent inflationary environment?
Right. No, that's consistent with the way we've looked at inflation, is that imbalance between demand and the supply constraints.
Is inflation causing an increase in mandatory spending because earned benefit programs and other mandatory spending programs are going up because there's a COLA or an index for cost of living, and that's causing tens of billions of dollars in increased cost to the taxpayers and in our budget forecast?
Yes, that's right. Inflation plays out into the mandatory spending and then also into the interest costs, because higher inflation translates into higher interest rates.
Why are interest going up? Are interest going up to try to tamp down on inflation by causing growth to recede so that we can cool off this cost of living crisis? Aren't interest hikes directly related to inflation, which I would submit are directly related to the overspending and the squeezing of the supply side? Is that a fair characterization?
No, I think that's right, that the Fed responded to the high interest rates by taking action to high inflation by taking action to raise interest rates.
I try to be careful not to blame the president for everything or my Democrat colleagues for everything, but I think their failed economic policies and their unbridled spending has put us in a situation where we have to bring these costs down. Let's talk about the interest for a minute. Prior to President Biden taking office, your projections over the 10 years for interest expense mm-hmm. related to servicing the debt was about $4.5 trillion. Mm-hmm. Today, it's over $12 trillion. I think that the interest cost for the year the president took office was about $340 billion. Today, your new projection is, as I said, higher than the expense of the national defense of the greatest country and military in the world, $870 billion. Is that a fair depiction of our balance sheet and some of these factors?
Yeah, no, absolutely. That, as you said, interest costs are now above defense spending.
So Republicans were much maligned for pushing back on the debt ceiling. It was, to me, a flashing red light, if not yellow, saying your debt is now at the highest levels, debt to GDP. The path is unsustainable. The unfunded liability, 30 years out, $120 trillion. And we were accused of being reckless for saying, wait a minute, we have an opportunity to have a conversation. Republicans led the debt ceiling negotiations. As a result, we got the FRA deal. Some of us, including me, thought it should be a more aggressive at reducing spending on the discretionary side. But regardless, the bipartisan outcome was a reset of the baseline and slower growth in discretionary, saving $1.6 trillion. Is that a fair characterization?
Right, and that's what you see in our projections. The change in the deficit, the lower deficit, is coming from those legislative actions.
Well, my time's expired.